This is the first in a series of videos focusing on eclipses. Let us first consider the shadow an object casts due to a point source. Because the light comes from only one point, the shadow's edges are sharply defined. We call the shadow the umbra. If an observer's eye is inside the umbra, they can't see the source at all. Light from distant stars are good point sources, but most light sources, including the sun, are not point sources. They are extended sources. If you look at the shadow cast by the ball due to the lamp, which is an extended source, you'll see two different parts of the shadow: the darker central region and the lighter shadow around it. The darker shadow, the umbra, is a cone of finite length. The lighter part of the shadow is called the penumbra, which is a cone of infinite length. If an observer's eye is inside the penumbra, they can see part of the source, but not all of it. To exaggerate this effect, we'll now use a larger extended source. When the ball is close to the screen, we can once again see the umbra surrounded by the penumbra. When the ball is moved farther from the screen, the umbra no longer reaches the screen, and we see the antumbra surrounded by the penumbra. We can see how the earlier umbra is not as dark as the present antumbra when comparing the two. The umbra is the region that does not receive any light due to the position of the eclipsing object, while the penumbra and antumbra are partially illuminated. Let's check our understanding with a peer instruction question. If I take a slice of the shadow cast by Earth due to the sun, its cross-sectional area may look like which of the following? Classroom students should follow normal procedures or instructor guidelines. Viewers not in the classroom should record your vote and explain your reasoning on a piece of paper. Please pause this video and answer the question. The sun acts as an extended source, so we'll never see just the umbra. It is possible to take a slice of the shadow near Earth that has the umbra and penumbra, or farther from the Earth that has the penumbra and antumbra. The classic demonstration for lunar and solar eclipses can be done with an orange and a cherry tomato. To visualize a lunar eclipse, we have our tomato, which represents the moon, pass through the shadow cast by the orange that represents Earth. It is possible to show a total lunar eclipse as the tomato passes completely through the umbra, a partial eclipse where only a portion of the tomato passes through the umbra, and a penumbral eclipse as the tomato passes only through the penumbra. To demonstrate a solar eclipse, we watch the tomato pass in front of the orange and allow it to represent the shadow that the moon casts on the Earth. Although this demonstration is useful for discussing, it is not remotely close to the correct scale. The Earth's radius is about 4 times that of the Moon. The Moon-Earth distance varies, but averages about 60 Earth radii. This eclipse stick is a scale model of the Earth-Moon system such that the model Earth has a radius of 1.5 inches. The Earth-Moon distance in the model is at the shorter end of its range of values. Using this to demonstrate a total lunar eclipse, we can see that the Moon passes through the penumbra and then the umbra, and that the entire night side of the Earth will see the lunar eclipse. Demonstrating a solar eclipse allows us to see that the shadow of the moon on the Earth is pretty small. Only those in the umbra of the moon shadow, the Grace Watch from Oregon to South Carolina, could see a total solar eclipse. Others, not in the path of totality, will see a partial solar eclipse if they're in the penumbra, or no eclipse at all if they're not in the shadow of the moon. In the August 2017 eclipse, the path of totality was roughly 70 miles across. When demonstrating eclipses, it can be challenging to get Earth and the Moon lined up perfectly with the Sun such they will pass through each other's shadows. More teaching materials can be found on the web at astro.unl.edu.